Are those front-end preload modifications then going to pay big dividends for Bagnaia? The field, sweep down the pit lane. Off-screen at the moment, Fabio De Gianantonio has gone through the first sector up by a tenth and a half as he attacks on fresh Michelin rubber. Brilliant job by the Grazzini racing rider at the moment, who does hold one of those all-important top 10 spots right now. He's seventh at the moment on the number 49 bike. There he is. We pick him up, being pursued by Quartararo. Through turn eight, fourth gear, 230 comes now, the former Hayshed. Now you'll start the climb up towards this beautiful left-hander, Lukey Heights, turn nine, and down to this tricky braking zone for turn 10. He just drops that right leg. You can just see there, a little bit of chat on the front end. No problems, 04, did you? Good lap this, potentially going up to fourth place. Superb first sector, he nailed it, the Italian. And now he's going to use all of that Ducati power then to blast out of the final corner on the run down the Garner Straight towards the finish line. Is it going to be P4 for Didier? Is it going to be even better for the Italian? Over the line he comes in, it's better. A 1:28.452. And the Gianantonio slots himself up into second place.
Oh, congratulations, Fabio. Great job. I was just thinking as he put that last sector together, he's hungry, he's brave, he's skilled, he wants to prove he's good enough to stay here, needs a job. And, yeah, Mark's... Is it? No,
it's
that's
Mia.
His teammate.
Yeah, Mark's there.
I'm sure both of them have picked him, and he keeps trying to dive out of it.
So there's some psychological games going on here, because Jorge Martin is also in this group, trying to follow Bagnaia. And Martin's thinking, well, oh, OK, I'm in P1 as it stands anyway. What, 1:28.299?
Yep.
Beckett, you've got, I tell you what, so you've got to be so, so careful when you do that, because you're risking dropping the temperature out of the tyres, aren't you, when you cruise like
and
that?
And the second thing is he's already lost that lap because he came onto the front straight too slow. So this next lap won't do it. He's got to use the whole lap, which is damaging that left-hand side of the rear tyre. What a lap from Vinales.
He might need another superhero costume very, very quickly, Maverick Vinales.
So Pecco, I don't believe, can do it this lap, like Jorge's caught up to him. He's using that left-hand side of the tyre on a lap that's not going to get him anywhere. So, wow, as Binder just goes,
super. 1:27.943. That's creeping so, so close to Martin's all-time lap record. His pole here 1 year ago, 1:27.767. Look at this, though. Pecco Bagnaia is towing his arch championship rival Jorge Martin to the best time of this session. Martin's been nudged back down to third place. It looks like his 1:28.299 will get him comfortably into Q2, but he just wants the psychological advantage here. He's going to pick up some great slipstream as they come through as well.
And down the front straight, he's going to get a slipstream. So Pecco, it all comes down now to, did he save enough of the left-hand side of that soft rear tyre to put another lap together?
So Bagnaia dragging Martin over the finish line, and Martin lost out time. Bagnaia, then, it's all on here. The world champion, 18 points clear. The man is behind him. Martin's called this one off. Martin's rolled out of it. So Jorge Martin is not going to be topping this practice session by the looks of it. It is all on, though, Bagnaia. This is a big lap. He might get one more in after this one, but he's down in 17th place. Surely Bagnaia is not going to be going into Q1 for the second race in succession. As always, the world champion digging deep, drops the anchor hard on the front end of that Ducati into the Miller corner. Look at the lean angle he gets there through that first gear, turn four. Then now he runs through the kink, turn five. Flicks it left through Siberia. Closest corner we sit to the ocean, to the Bass Strait. And now he starts building the power up through this wonderful sector three, through seven, eight, and nine. All fourth gear through there, then back one gear to the third gear, Lukey Heights. Quick check then on Bagnaia. He has now been pushed back down to 18th place. That's because Luca Marini, who's had a real tough opening day here in Australia, has gone up into 17th spot.
He's going to be safely in if he can put this lap together. 4 tenths downhill. 16th? No.
Well, he's going to have one more lap in it. Overline Bagnaia. Miller is doing a great job on the factory KTM, cheering up the home fans. Miller up into fourth place, potentially getting better for the Aussie as well on the factory KTM. Bagnaia then comes to the finish line, 18th place right now, and that's not good enough. A 1:28.642, 11th for Pecco Bagnaia. He got the line for one more lap at it. Did he run in a little bit wide there in the first corner? Not quite. He did.
He did.
Or did he pull out of it? It was either a mistake by Bagnaia, he pulled out of it. So for the second week in a row, Pecco Bagnaia is going to find himself in that opening 15-minute Q1 session. Martin's going to go through. Checkered flag is out. Jack Miller did indeed with a superb late charge of a 1:28.09. The Aussie in his home Grand Prix fires himself up into second. Fabio Quartararo is really angry and frustrated with
was
somebody.
Was Pecco apologising then? What was going on? Was Pecco in front?
Who is this?
That's Fabio, but it's...
It's Augusto Fernandez.
Yes.
Where Quartararo wanted to put that factory Yamaha sign, wasn't it?
That's horrible.
Yeah, I think Augusto may well have an appointment with the FIM MotoGP stewards because frustration, that has dumped Quartararo into Q1 as well.
KTM first and second.
Awesome.
I can't remember that happening before.
Not
first
too...
and second.
Very, 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 very rare. Doesn't happen very often on a Friday, does it? Martin, then, is he going to produce the fourth sector of his life around Phillip Island? Look how hard he's pushing that rear tyre. It's screaming for traction as he comes out of the final corner. Is Jorge Martin going to snatch top spot late on here? Over the line, he comes already in Q2, no problems. Stays in fourth. They can see under investigation, as we suspected it would be. Quartararo was clearly impeded there. He wanted to put that factory Yamaha right where Augusto Fernandez was. But for the second Friday in a week, there is drama that's come the way of Pecco Bagnaia. He is going to be going into Q1 tomorrow.
I just can't believe he's put himself in that position again. You know, because he's got the speed to do it. Just getting distracted with other riders, trying not to tow them around. He threw that first lap away by mucking around, trying to get rid of riders behind him. He threw it away, like came onto the front straight too slow, so that lap's gone. And then next lap, the tyre's not quite as good.
Yeah.
The one after that he didn't get to do, it would be worse again.
It's perplexing, isn't it? It is.
But let's give Brett Binder a shout out.
100%.
What an effort. I honestly had a feeling he felt confident because he could do it at will every time we go down track. Impressive lap, but how impressive is that one?
Seen a few South African fans in the paddock here this weekend. They are going to be delighted, aren't they? Binder then with the only 1:27 lap of the weekend so far. He tops that practice session by nearly a tenth and a half. A Red Bull KTM Factory Racing 1-2. Brad Binder does like this Phillip Island circuit. He's had wins in Moto2 and Moto3 back in the day. Vinales was third. Martin was fourth. Paul Espargaro, top job on the Gas Factory Racing Tech 3 machine. He's fifth. Betsecki was sixth. This was at turn 10.
Oh, that's the old
4
save.
Years ago.
Look at this. Going to U-turn on the grass.
Was that the... Yeah, there we go. That was the acknowledgement straight to the crowd. Yeah. What do you think of that one, folks? That was the 70-degree one, wasn't it? This was today where he tried so, so hard for history to repeat itself. It didn't quite happen. 3 or 4 times. You couldn't see it from that camera angle. He was digging that right near.
Almost. It was almost a replica.
It was a top effort, wasn't it? We'll give him 8 out of 10 for effort.